should be up.
Let's see.
Am I up, people? Can you see me? Yes.
There we go.
That was a lot. Hey everyone, how are you doing tonight?
See who is on the stream.
I have to post this up. So let's get started, guys. We'll post this up. We will get started with this. All right, everyone. So how are everyone doing tonight? Yeah, you gotta reload. I just changed it now, Cosmic, so yes.
We are going to play, and Knocker was right when he said it was in his late night stream.
Nightmare in the Dark from Neo Geo. I had this game imported from Japan, and I was really... My voice is that... Can you guys hear me now? Fine. You should be able to hear me now. I don't see why not.
Oh, is this a bad echo?
No, really? I wonder why. I don't see any... Let's see if this works. How about this? Is this better? I don't know why. That's kind of weird. Let's take a look. Let's see. How is it now? Alright, yeah, it was some streaming crap thing that I had that I was playing around with because I just got the Stream Deck, so I was like, let me try it out and stuff, but yeah, the Stream Deck gets too much into it. So, Nightmare in the Dark, like, give you guys like just brief history on this one. I played this one when I was... I saw an arcade, Neo Geo. This had this game in it. It had Samurai Showdown and it had Last Blade 2, which is weird. So, the local arcade. I played this a lot. I kept on playing, and I kind of really liked the game. Then, it's a great game. I really like it. This game. Is the whole reason why I bought the Neo Geo to begin with is because I just happen to love this game, Mark of the Wolves, and Last Blade 2, which I all own for the Neo Geo. But this one I happen to really just like. I fell in love with it. It's all about a guy. Basically, it's this, he patrols, like, the graveyard and everything, and then, you know... come midnight, all these ghouls and stuff start popping out and everything like that. So, we're going to get started on this. I'm using the actual Neo Geo system. I got the arcade controller from the CDZ. Hopefully this one will actually work just a little bit better than the other one that I was using, but I'm going to tell you guys right now, not the most exciting game to stream. Cosmic could definitely tell you that, but it's still a really good Really good game. Even if you're going to try to go for like a high score challenge, this is definitely the game to do it. So, Knocker, if you got a Neo Geo and you want to do a high score challenge between you and I, I'm down for this game, buddy, whenever you're ready. Little thing between you and me. I was not on Scantlines when this one came out, or else I definitely would have done it. Because I happen to truly do love this game. But I'm definitely looking forward to Athena. But you could do it like a ROM emulation or something, right, Knocker? That would be pretty cool. If you had the ROM for this, that would be awesome. You did a really good job last night with Ghouls and Ghosts. I'm actually gonna try that tonight just to see what was going on. If I can even like try to beat the game for Genesis. So, Cosmic, what was your score in this game? How far did you get? Oh, okay. My range up. And you got to use the ball to hit the other guys and launch it, like what I just did right here with the double points. No! Definitely love to see that. There's no game audio. I don't know. I gotta figure out why there's no game audio. Might be something to do with OBS. I don't know. You're not missing much with the game audio, I'll tell you that. Oh, he's gonna pound me. My setup is a little bit. I'm gonna let time go out, just so we can like try to figure out what's going on with this. But let's have a look. So you're telling me there's no game audio at all, huh? That's pretty interesting. Yeah, I'm not. Don't know why. It might be something with OBS, but I'll have to go back and take a look just to see. Oh, RVK beat you. Wow. Yeah, I don't have my memory card in for this. This game is on the Switch? Wait, this game really is on the Switch? I never knew that before. It's kind of weird. I'm getting audio out of... Oh, okay, okay. Yeah. So, Mew, what do you think? Because I have that. Do you think that's a version that maybe we could play for the high score, you know, for the challenge? Oh, it's not really a challenge. What is it? It's for the review, right? I always get those mixed up. Oh, yeah, and Saturn version for House of the Dead is on American Saturn version is ridiculously expensive. I'll tell you guys that much. That thing is like a lot of money. So, we'll see. Oh, really? So, RetroArch, it doesn't work on RetroArch, basically. So, let me ask you guys something. Is RetroArch... Is RetroArch like something that you could, is it free or do you have to pay for the services for RetroArch? Like what goes on with RetroArch? I was still trying to debate that. Oh, so it's free. So how does RetroArch work? Because to be honest with you guys, like I have 27 systems, and those are hooked up to Knocker. This is going back to what you asked. Going into my I have a 27-inch CRT that I have everything hooked up to. I have 18 port switch. An 18 2. Port 8 and 8, 6, 2, 6, 2, 8 port switches that I use for RGB that run into a 4-port splitter for the red, yellow, and white cables composite, and then that goes into a converter. Because this TV is so old, it's an RCA, it's an old TV, that it only has coaxial, nothing else. So I have a coaxial converter going into the TV. So then that goes into the RetroTank 5X, and then from there it goes into the HDMI video capture, which is basically what you guys are seeing now. But I have all the systems like in front of me. You name it, I probably can stream on whatever the hell you want. I'm using a normal HDMI. I honestly, my friend told me about it. So, you do have component though. Component is component the multicolor ones, or is component, are red, green, and no, I thought it was composite. I believe I have composite. Component are the ones that I always get these confused. So I was like an RF generation child and. Yeah, I don't have the red. I don't have the red, green, and blue. I have the red, white, and yellow. So those are, I believe those are composite or component, whatever they are. when it came to the video and stuff, like my friend kind of helped me like all hook it up and everything. The RF video I had to figure out quickly because I wanted to play the 5200 and I had to go to a computer store near me and get all the cables and hook everything up. You probably could, Knocker, to be honest with you. I mean, it's not, you know. So that's why you guys were like, oh, Sunset Riders. I was like, oh, I have that for Super Nintendo. I can just stream that and we can just you know, we can go from there. But this with the whole, you guys not being able to hear the audio, that's things. I'll figure that out once I get off, once we, you know, figure out the stream and stuff. It's done. All right, he's going to call forth his boys, and I'm going to throw the ball at him. I think Cosmic, he's a fairly easy boss, per se. Yeah, he's pretty easy. Cool looking boss though. Very nice game. When you think of horror games, like when I think of horror games, this is the type of game that I think of. I'm like, yeah, this is a great game. I don't do Elgato at all. I won't do Elgato. I just don't like Elgato to begin with. So I have a lot of trouble with OBS. That's why I've been putting a lot of investigation into the whole thing with Streamlabs. And I think Streamlabs is probably the way to go for me. So I'm probably going to start be using Streamlabs in the next stream for Sunday night. If Foxy said there was nothing going on a Wednesday, oh, don't get the skull. Thank you, Cosmic. Foxy said there's nothing going on Wednesday. I might want to stream, and I'm probably thinking about maybe streaming Zero Kamikaze Squirrel or something else for Genesis. Or Mazin Saga. It's another great game. Alicia Dragoon. The potions are upgrades, yeah. Your upgrades stay with you, right? Like, the upgrades are for the full game? And Knocker, do you own a Neo Geo? Or do you just, like, remember playing this like me as a kid and just fell in love with it? I have Kamikaze Squirrel for SNES and for Sega Genesis, both complete. Except the box for Super Nintendo is pretty bad. I picked it up when Blockbuster was closing. Am I stuck? Nope. It's the controller. I need a new Neo Geo controller. That's going to have to come from Japan. Yep. I didn't think... Well, I wanted to stream. I don't know. Let me ask you guys something. Are you guys interested in... I don't know if anyone would be. But is anyone interested in seeing a... Atari Jaguar stream with some games. Oh, we're going to have to change the controller, guys. I knew this one was a little... The SNES version's pretty decent. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, we're going to have to... Yeah, see? When I hit left... I think I've been grinding out Mark of the Wolves a little bit too much. I will change the controller. Try this again. We'll use my other Neo Geo controller. You are the first person, Knocker, that has said that, and I think it's crazy, but growing up, yeah, man, we used to call Jaguar the toilet bowl of video game systems. It was bad, bro. It was bad. Jaguar was bad. Game over, second boss. Okay. Much better controller now. Two, five. Okay. Oh, yeah, my score is... How high can you get? I don't know. Let's find out. I was... Tell you guys the truth. I was secretly hoping that Star Tropics made it to the thing tonight, but yeah, I was hoping because I love Star Tropics, but it's cool. So I was gonna ask Slippy if Wednesday was free, and I was gonna stream one of my most favorite games, which is Lords of Thunder. That game is I think everyone should take a look at that game, and you know, even if you get like yourself a PC Engine emulation or something like that, just stream that game. I've never heard anything about a Jaguar. I mean, I've heard things about Jaguar, but Star Tropics, man. Star Tropics, I played Star Tropics a lot. It's a hard game, but it's a really good game. Yeah, this controller moves so much better. I've seen a 3DO before. I had a chance to get a 3DO before the pandemic started. I never really took up the offer because I didn't know what I was essentially getting myself into with the 3DO. So I kind of just never really got it to begin with. Oh, he gave me good. I want that chest. I'm not going to get that chest. No, that was bad. I would love to know, Knocker, because the only real game that I'm like a huge Castlevania nut. I love the whole franchise. I mean, like I loved everything about Castlevania. I never like, I'm a little tired over, like, the Halloween games. Like, once the Halloween games are over, I'm kind of looking for... I'm kind of excited to see, you know, like, what else can I open up in the library for the games. I definitely want, and I kind of agree with Foxy... Garfield Caught in the Act. Gonna probably stream that eventually. November, I'll open up to a lot of games. I think for Christmas, though, and I think you guys could probably guess it, would be Knight's Christmas for Sega Saturn. So, I have that one. Definitely play that. But, yeah, Lords of Shadow... Lords of Thunder is a great, absolutely great game, guys. I will stream with you, buddy. I have that game. I love that game. It is a great game. I also have Noah's Ark and Joshua that I can play as well. So, yes, and I will I will bust out Little Samson and play that one too, if need be, for Christmas. I mean, really, when you think of Christmas, I always think of Christmas Nights. I'm like, Christmas Nights is awesome, so... Christmas Nights is... It was a great game. I mean, Nights was a great game when Saturn, you know, came out in its prime and stuff, but... So, what do you guys have planned for Halloween? Anything interesting, you know, going on? Any games, like, you know, you guys remember growing up and playing during Halloween? Like, what was your best? Like, did you guys, you know, like, growing up, did you have any, like, really crazy Halloween experiences? You know, going to, like, KB Toys or Toys R Us or something and pick up, like, a really weird video game or something? There's always those... weird Halloween stories. I mean, I remember getting Ghoul School, and I was like, wow, like, this is great. Halloween was always big in my house anyway, so. Knocker, why don't you, if you have any NES simulation, why don't you do a Nightmare on Elm Street or Friday the 13th? Those are two, obscure horror games that came out for Nintendo. Those are pretty cool to stream. I mean, Nightmare on Elm Street was crazy when that came out as a kid. Halloween was always awesome. I went to Salem one year, and it was a tad bit crazy. Didn't expect all the nunniness to happen there, but it is Salem, so. So, yeah, you guys have any, like, Halloween games that you guys remember playing, like, as you were little? I'll tell you this much. My mother was a school teacher, and she used to have her kids come over. And I remember one time we played The Little Mermaid on NES, and it stuck with me, and I played The Little Mermaid a lot on NES, and to this day, I think I'll still... get rammed by this guy. All right, Cosmic, I need some help. What's the strat for this guy? I forgot. You just gotta stay away. This guy's gonna tank me. You know, you could always play. Oh. Oh, okay. I like Castlevania 4. I honestly, Castlevania 4 is a great opening. I think it's just an overall great game. No. Friday the 13th. Yeah, Friday the 13th for NES. Just crazy the way the back of the box looks and everything. Man, and this is even before they had ratings on the game. Because I'm almost certain this game probably had a ridiculous rating on it, that's for sure. This is a four-player game. Back in the day, man, you didn't have, you weren't like, oh, wow, four-player, whatever it was. But, yeah, I mean, this was a crazy game growing up. You know, four players, you'd have Freddy come after you. It's not a bad game. I have Friday the 13th, but I don't have it complete in box. Ghoul School is another good game to play. That game's awesome. Let's try this again. I could sit and play this game for a long, like, I really do enjoy playing this game. Like, sometimes, like, my friends will ask me, oh, you want to raid in, like, Destiny or do something? And I kind of say, nah, I'm not going to be on tonight. And they just sit and really just play this game a lot because it's just a really good game. But yeah, I can see that we're not getting coming. We're getting games down here. House of the Dead was a good game. In fact, thank you for bringing that up, Cosmic New. Let me ask you, is it, for what you were asking for the review, can we play the Switch version? Is it possible? Like, would that be considered a review for the game, I guess? Because I know Saturn's version, America, and like the American version for Saturn, is a lot of money. I think it actually is, believe it or not. I think it is a remake. I think it is. To go out again, I don't have the American version to that one. I don't know if it came out for Dreamcast. I know my friend has Typing of the Dead for Dreamcast. Yeah, and I agree, Cosmic. It's a great game. Like I said, this game is the reason why I went out and I bought a Neo Geo. And I searched for a Neo Geo. When I tell you guys, it took me close to about 5 years to get an AES. House of the Dead 2. Yeah, it took me about 5 years to get an AES. Because they were just over the top, ridiculously priced. I happen to score big with this one when I got it. And I was buying games for the AES too, and I didn't even own an AES, which was crazy. And this was one of them. I said I bought this, and I was like, I want it. It's a ROM. So when you deal with Neo Geo, you have to understand that there's certain things with, like, when you get into the Neo Geo stuff, there's ROM ports of an MVS, which the MVS is the, like you saw when Foxy put up, that's the arcade machine. So they do ROM ports. This is a ROM port of the actual game because, like, you can see on the box, it's not... It looks legit. It's got, like, the legit, Neo Geo box when you open it up, but normal Neo Geo boxes usually have something inside of here. I have the little plastic thing it came with for, you know. But, yeah, the guy was like, it's a port of, and it was from Japan. He's like, it's a port of the MVS. Do you want it? And I said, yeah, sure, I'll do it. Just really saw this game, fell in love with it, and I don't know, everything kind of fell in the right spot when it came to the Neo Geo, getting that, and when it came to getting the port of this game. This is definitely a top three. And what's interesting, too, is no one, we were talking about Castlevania, right? So, Knocker, I don't know if this one's right up your alley or not, but we're really, really going through Castlevania. No one mentioned Vampire Hunter D for PlayStation. And that game is ridiculously cheap right now for some reason, for a PS2 game. Damn, I got that. Oh, wow. Yeah, I didn't even know that Mew. Cosmic, I never knew that. Thank you for letting me know that one. So Cosmic, do you Vampire Hunter D, Knocker? Cosmic, do you own a Neo Geo, or you just did you just basically just stream this on a ROM? Okay. I was very surprised because I have the gold, the Neo Geo gold, and it wasn't on there for some reason. I don't know why. And this was a big game. Like, a lot of people happen to like this game. Oh, really? No, I own... So, I own, for Neo Geo, Knocker, I own the Neo Geo Gold... that came out. It's like a portable handheld system. I could do a game review on that. I own the Neo Geo arcade stick. It's a gigantic stick in a yellow box. I own the Neo Geo CDZ. I own the CD. And I own the AES. I never had a Neo Geo growing up. Always the rich kids had the Neo Geo growing up. Because, let's face it, guys, I mean, how much were those games for Neo Geo? I mean, come on. They're a lot of money. They still are. I mean, God, you will look up Mark of the Wolves and see how much that is. But this game, it was reasonably priced. I got it, I think, for $100. Guy threw in, like, a lot of nice little things with it, so... Well, Knocker, the things you're going to want to know about Neo Geo is it's expensive. It's expensive. And it's expensive to collect. I don't have a lot of games for it. I started buying games back in 2004. It did have a lot of good games. You are right. Is he going to get ready to ram me? Come on, buddy. Oh, yeah. I think one of my favorite Neo Geo game is Mark of the Wolves. I knew he was going to... I knew... Oh! Puts me all the way down here, too. All right, guys. Oh, when I was invis. Lucky on that one. Yeah, Mark of the Wolves, Last Resort, this, and anything Fatal Fury-esque. He does this weird thing, yeah, like he's gonna go all the way back and hit you. I saw that. The carts on Neo Geo are huge. I don't know why. I hate these ghosts. I can't stand these ghosts. But yeah, Neo Geo's crazy. What? Oh. I think this one you gotta funnel the balls, right? This would be considered the third boss, I take it. I was in the right place at the right time with that one. Not that one. Oh, I didn't get it. Not in enough time anyway. The fourth boss is easy. So, Cosmic, how long did it take you to beat this? Because I think with 0-0s, I'm probably not going to get a good ways here. Oh, you never beat it. Wow. Game over. I would love to try to make it to the last boss, but I'm going to try. I'm really going to try to see how far I can get in this tonight. Because I could sit and play this game for hours. Yeah, but if you guys want to know anything about the Neo Geo or whatever it is, ask away and stuff. I mean, I know enough about it. If you guys have any questions or anything. Gonna drop him. I want to try to go for a score. I do. I really wanna. I want to try to see how far I can get and how high I can get in the game. Every time I play this, I always try to do that. Okay. So are you guys hearing the audio off the game, or you're still not, is the game not giving you audio at all? You're just only hearing me. Because then once. Oh, don't get hit. Oh, I missed. I like the design of the first stage on this. So for the high score challenge in this, who brought this one up? Who said, oh, let's play Nightmare in the Dark? Okay. I'm surprised. It's a great game. Okay. I try to keep it going. It's a good choice. Cosmic, How did you find out about this game? I thought I was like really a couple of other people. Oh, like Ice Climbers. Okay. Or Snow Brothers, right? It's a very unique game, that's for sure. Not really something you would like see within like the arcade, but I mean, from what I was told from the guy that I bought this from, he's like, yeah, this game, a lot of people happen to go nuts over in Japan, so it became very popular, and that's why they ported it out to the MVS system. Come on, come on, come on. Oh, I got two balls, like, right there. I never had... Okay. Never did I have the liberty of picking up the Snow Brothers. Oh, did that work? There you go. Snow Brothers is expensive. Like, I don't, like, it's just never had the liberty of getting it. It's like, never, you know, Snow Brothers, all that stuff. I got in Zombie Nation. I collect. Being an only child, it was a lot more towards video games really than anything. You know, it's funny you bring that up, Cosmic, because, you know, talking with Knocker and Slippy a lot, there's a lot of retro achievements on RetroArch. And I'm seeing, like, I would really like to try that out and play that. So, and maybe stream and, you know, stream some RetroArch games. Because right now, really, guys, the only thing I'm doing is I'm streaming, like, everything I have, basically on the systems I have. But I guess RetroArch would leave me with being able to stream a little bit more. More content than what, you know, originally I have. But I've been collecting since, I think, 94? 90, whenever the SNES came out, that's when I started collecting. But I mean, it's, you know, collecting's fun, but now in our days, it stinks. It's not fun at all. So I think your best way to go is RetroArch. So let me ask, for RetroArch, like, obviously you said it's free. Do you have to have all the ROMs to go in there and play, or are all the ROMs included as well? And Knocker, you were saying something about MAME, right? I was trying to look for a good MAME thing, like a MAME engine or something for Dragon Ball Z, because I know you have like all those. Oh no, that was Mugen, but I know MAME. You can have some great Dragon Ball Z games on there that people homebrew. Yeah, you're not taking me this time, buddy. Your friends are gonna take me. Watch. Oh, that was horrible. Gotta make that jump. I was right. Wow, this turned out to be a crapshoot. Yeah, this is bad. This is even hard for me to watch. How are you guys even watching this? This is hard. I'm just getting rammed. Guess strats would be to stay up here, hit them, freeze them, throw the ball. Ah, I see. I see now. So, does anyone like Battletoads? Has anyone ever played like Battletoads before? Tanked. Come on, come on. Boom. Oh, that was beautiful. Let's see. So, Grim, how are you going? How are you tonight? What's going on? That jump was pretty bad. Come on. Can I? You see, he should have froze. Oh, I gotta get that. Yeah. It is hard, they say. Is it like a top collector's game, Battletoads? I see a lot of people go nuts over it. Probably not going to make that, or am I? Nope. Alright, let's go. Carry this. And let's go down. No, I know. I heard Battletoads. I mean, I've never ever played Battletoads before. So I was kind of curious if anyone else. No, 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 no. Oh, come on. Wonder if anyone else ever played it. I know a lot of people say they like Battletoads. Seen a lot of people play that. Oh man, that wasn't even my highest score. I got a top up there. I got to try to beat that. And I was on 3-4, not 2-5. Huh. Let's try this again. Yeah, I don't know why. So, Cosmic, do you, like, when you stream and stuff like that, it's just right off the computer, right? What controller do you use, like, when you stream? Is it like a regular game computer, like a regular game controller? Hey, Pixel, what's going on? Yo, I can't even beat an easy game, let alone a hard game. I mean, if I really, it's not like, you know, growing up, it was like, oh my God, let's do Star Tropics, let's play this and that. I'm good, Pixel. Thank you for asking. We're playing a little Nightmare in the Dark on the Neo Geo. All right, fire up. I'm going to chill right there. I'm going to collect everything. Knock this guy out. Let's go. stand here, pick it up, move on to the next round. So, Pixel, I was asking if you had any, like, Halloween games or any of those games that, you know, you thought were, like, pretty cool growing up, you know, that you normally played around, like, Halloween time. Like, what, you know, video game-wise, like, what's the nostalgia with Halloween? Like, do you have any awesome Halloween games? Usually a lot of people just talk about Castlevania. All right, let's do this. Let's go. That's probably going to go to the end. Any games, like, growing up that you played? I mean, I said one time, I Halloween for me is always the... I used to play The Little Mermaid a lot. I don't know. We had a bunch of friends come over when I was growing up. That was the game of choice. Don't ask me why, but that's what it was. Can you lower that? Your thing is so loud. I like it. It's a good game for NES. I have it for Genesis. Never played it for Genesis. November for me. I don't know why I'm very like, oh, you know, I played this game this month and this game this... November's really, like, Eco the Dolphin for some reason. I don't know why. I used to play a lot of Eco in November. And there go all my upgrades. Eco was a lot of fun. Not Tides of Time, though. I mean, Tides of Time was kind of weird. I mean, if you play Eco for... Dreamcast? It's not bad for Dreamcast. It's like 3D. Alright, let's start hitting this guy up. Let's throw the ball. Nope, we're not getting that. Backgrounds on this game are amazing, too. The way everything is all, like, integrated, it looks pretty cool, I will admit. Oh, man. Alright, let's go. Oh, it charged me. I'm in a really bad spot. I'm going to try to trap this guy. Bam, one shot. There you go. Hopefully I get a good score on this. All right, let's... There you go. Alright, let's jump up here. I'm gonna cut down. And I'm gonna wait, and I'm gonna jump up here. And jump up one more time. Got it. Okay. I disappear, and stage 2-4. All right, cool. Let's try this. I think I could group this guy together if I hit him quick enough. All right, that was a good move. Hey, what's up, Slippy? We are playing Nightmare in the Dark. And I am moving way too slow. I gotta get this chest. Got it. Okay. There's something wrong with the audio for the game. I think it's capture card related. I don't know. The audio is coming out of the TV fine. So I think it has something to do with OBS. That was rough. Oh, that was rough. That was rough, too, to watch. I'm just going to drop down in here. I don't know how this guy hit me when... Oh, come on. Throw your stuff down. Let's go. Throw your little skeleton dudes. You are not taking my life anymore, buddy. This guy has tanked me a couple of times now. So the thing with this guy is, I guess I just have to wait for his little buddies to come. Drop up here. Take him. Throw him on him. And that's it. Oh. See, you shot one guy right there. Oh, I got this guy now. That was so well placed. So, Slippy, we were going through a retro arc, and, yeah, like, maybe I should get into retro arc and all that stuff. All that fun stuff. Nice. I got all those power-ups, guys. I think I'm in a good position. Alright, we got the deep forest. Let's see how this goes. I want to get into that. I want to use RetroArch. What I do is I usually just play whatever I have. So I have this on Neo Geo, so you do straight retro arc emulation? Oh no, you have the, I forgot, yeah, you got the, what is that? I forgot the name of that thing called. Mercer, no, whatever that thing, whatever, I forgot the name of it. Mister, that's it, right, Mister. Because you can play everything on the Mister, basically. What kind of card do you have in there? Like, what's the size? I mean, if you have all these games on the Mister, like, how? I mean, you got to have, like, what? The storage size on that? It's got to be huge to hold all these games. Audio, video, everything. Like, that's a lot. Oh, this guy's going to kill me. Oh, wow. Did I luck out with that one, Cosmic? Huh. Oh, wow. 3 terabyte? That's awesome, man. You could play every game in existence, and you won't even, like, collecting doesn't even faze you at all. That's so cool, though, with the Mister. That's awesome. I'm going to look into it. Yeah, I mean, I definitely get that. So, you, oh no, is this the boss Cosmic? Oh, hell no. I just got to the boss. I still have not beaten my top score. That was rough, but I'm getting better as we go along. Getting better. So let's see. Let's go. So I have a question. Do you guys want to see me? You want me to stream more of this? Or do you guys want me to stream? There was another game I was also thinking about today. It's not Halloween related. It's called Last Resort. It's a shoot 'em up on Neo Geo. Didn't know if you guys were interested in seeing that as well. Shoot 'em ups are, a lot of people are iffy about them, so let me know what you guys think in the comments. Definitely we could, you know, I could play that. That's one of my favorite Neo Geo games. And I'm done. Yeah, but Slippy, even now, like, collecting is garbage. Collecting's horrible. I mean, I'm looking at prices now, and, you know, Mew brought up, a really good game, okay? And it was House of the Dead. Great game. But on Saturn, like, just the normal Saturn version, the American Saturn version, like $550. I mean, where it's tough to collect now. I'll tell you that much. I mean, is the bubble gonna pop? Is it not gonna pop? And who knows? Cosmic, I think you have the right idea going, where you just don't collect, you just play to play to have fun, and you have all the games at your disposal anyway. So yeah, I mean, that's awesome, man. I mean, you can pretty much, like, play whatever you want, you know, do whatever you want. I mean, with the games, there's got to be tons of mods, too, that you could adjust on these games. Homebrews. Alright, we're on the boss stage now. This boss is easy. So you just play straight, like, whatever the game is. I would love to get into the homebrews of the Castlevanias that they have and the Zeldas. I think those seem kind of interesting. Castlevania 2 has a homebrew for it. I know. Oh, what else has a homebrew? Castlevania 2, Zelda. There's a lot of games to play. There's definitely a lot of games out there to play. I've always wanted to sit down and really play through Majora's Mask, but I've never had the time for it. always thought that was like a really awesome game to play. Chrono Trigger, if I could beat the Dragon Boss, that would be great on the bridge, but I can't. So, and I just picked up a game called Tactics Org for Super Nintendo. It's a translation of Tactics Org for Super Famicom. It was pretty cheap. It was on eBay. Wasn't a lot. I think it was like maybe 12, 13 bucks. Really looking forward to that one coming. I know there's a mod for Elden Ring where you could basically play as Millennia in the entire game, like, you know, throughout the entire game. That would be something I would be interested in at least trying. So that would definitely be interesting. All right, now moving up in the world. All right, let's go. Come on. Oh, that ghost. Should have waited on that ball. Got him out pretty quick. I'm not going to go on this boss. All right, I got plus two. Come on. All right, let's see. It's going to probably blow up at the end and give me a gem. Oh, wow, really? So, let me ask you, With the Elden Ring for uninterrupted multiplayer, right? Like, does that mean that you can, like, you and him can run around and, like, tag team on bosses and on other people? That's awesome. That is very awesome. What are you playing Elden Ring on? PC, obviously, right? I can hang out down here if I want to. Just set these idiots on fire. And die again and again and again. I heard it was amazing on PC. A lot of people recommended it to me on PC. A lot of people said, oh yeah, like check this out, it's really good. I never really tried it on PC. I know it got great ratings for it because of like the graphics and everything and the way it looks on PC, so. Oh, come on, man. Whoa, all right. See, when he rams the wall, I have to be far back. That way he won't hit me when he blasts forward. But his little friends have to, they gotta come down and fall into the ground. So let's let them fall down. Let's get them up and let's start throwing. All right, we're gonna hit the boss two more times. I'm not going to throw anything. I'm going to let his little goon friends come down. Oh, man, this boss gets me every time. Every time. Probably going to wipe on this boss. Yep, zero credits. Nope, and this boss is easy too, but wasn't doing that well. Let's see. Alright, here we go. We are on... I think this is the first, second, third, fourth stage, if I'm not mistaken. Look at the ghost. So, Slippy, Mew was in the chat, and he said something about the remake, and the remake is a touchscreen for House of the Dead on the Switch, but I don't know how accurate this is going to be because it's a remake. Bam. Oh, no. Oh, yeah, you didn't catch me, you little flea guy. I'm going to chuck my flames at you, buddy. Oh, so Slippy, we were going through Christmas games. And you have any, like, games you like to play around Christmas time? No. Oh, you fell. I said I normally like to play Knights, the Knights remix, the Knights remix on Saturn, Christmas Knights. Christmas Nights is a lot of fun. All right, so this is, I think, if can I ask Cosmic if this is the stage before the boss? Halloween and Christmas is a big thing here. My wife really gets into Christmas and Halloween, so normally play those games. Normally, I usually play, same here. That's about it. It's the only reason why. After that's... because my wife likes them, the kids and everybody, they all like, you know, they all like the holidays and stuff like that. Halloween I like. I like Halloween a lot, but that's it. Oh, geez. Here we go. Christmas Nights is fun. Oh, wow. They are ridiculously hard. They just come right after you. You really got to be on your toes with this one. Game over. Let's see. Nope. It's the same. Like, you know, my wife's really into, like, the holidays and stuff like that, so... Now, whatever, put up the tree and all the other stuff. I mean, Christmas is fun. I don't really get into watching, like, any of those Christmas movie type of things. Halloween, I'll get more into, really, than Christmas. Halloween I'll enjoy a lot more. I like more of the horror movies. Whoa, let's jump up here. And there we go. I'll usually do, like I said, I'll usually play Christmas nights. Nothing, you know, it's about it, really. I know, like, I play Destiny 2 a lot with a bunch of friends. So Destiny, we usually have a thing called The Dawning. We'll play that a lot. It's really like a holiday type of theme. Other than that, it's about it. Nope, we're not getting that. Alright, let's go. Okay, so stage 1-3. I honestly think, guys, if I get through that boss that keeps on ramming everyone, like, ramming all the time, I think I'll be good. What I want to do is I'm going to jump through the floor first, and I'm going to then jump up top, and I'm going to hang out up top. I think that would be a really good strat with that guy. I'm always getting tanked by him. And then when I come up to the stage with those gremlins, it's like I'm dying. I'm like, oh, this is great. I can't do this. So I gotta figure something out. I think that's what I'll do. Just try to go for as much power ups as possible. Go in there fully charged, you know, and hit them from there. We should be decent. Oh, we got a gem. We're good to go. Let's see. No, let's try to figure this out. All right, it's not this boss. I'm just going to jump up top. I'm going to jump down. All right, let's go, buddy. Come on. He's going to slam. And I'm going to toast his friends. I want that power up, but I'm not going to be able to get it. There's no way. Okay. Slippy, do you dress the dog up for Halloween? Okay, all right. Now my Pomeranian will objectively chew through the clothes, and she will not move. She will stand in one spot, and that's it. She will not move. She will become like a stiff statue. So yeah, we don't put her in clothes. Mine does that all the time. The little weenie dog I have, he does not like collars. He somehow found his collar and chewed it. So he didn't like his collar. He got annoyed about that. And he gets, you know, mad just with things. Doesn't like clothes, doesn't like anything. Wait, what? My dog will stand there. She hates the Pomeranian getting dressed up. She will stand there in one position and not move. You have to pick her up and put her places. She will not, she will, like, she looks like a statue when she just, when she stands there. It's crazy. The other nutcase, the other dog, he'll he'll just stand there and he'll chew through his clothes, and then you find his clothes in like little bits and pieces. Yeah, sure, Saiyan. I mean, Slippy. Come on. Okay. So, I go to Audio Mixer. Okay, now what do I do from there? On my microphone, okay. So, advanced audio properties. Go to click mono for audio import capture. Okay, let me see here. Active. It says everything is active for the audio. Oh, I never knew that. Okay. How is this? Is this better now or no? Let me know. Because I have the audio. Okay. Oh, mic and auxiliary. This is audio input capture. Try this one. Let's see. Advanced audio properties. That should be a lot better, I guess. I know. I think OBS took a dump on me. Really, I think I got to redo OBS or move all the properties to Streamlab and then figure that out. Not the best with OBS, guys. We'll admit Streamlabs. Like Streamlabs a little bit better, but you can't change your stream key for some reason. It's set. Well, but whatever. Streamlabs, I could change my stream key. It's Twitch that I can't do it. The Twitch Studio. Alright, let's see how far we get in this one. But yeah, the audio's not working. Would my audio sound fine and everything? Like, would you hear it fine? Oh, then I might have changed it. I might have, yeah, because I went to the what you told me to and I chose mono. The whole thing is the game audio, and I think it's because I have to refresh the capture card over and over again every time I bring up OBS, because I don't keep the capture card in the PC. I cannot believe this guy fell down, and yeah, I got hit. That's interesting. I really want to try to beat this guy without dying. So my whole strat is to make it may stay up here. Is yours set to mono too? I guess, yeah, right? No BS? Yeah, let me pause this. Let me catch up in the chat. Oh, Steam games. I could definitely see that. I am no good at Mega Man games. I never really had a good experience with a Mega Man game. I mean, X2 I like. They're fun games. I have X3, never played X3. And I just bought the Mega Man games now. I have 8 and everything else. I should. I'll do it tomorrow. Whenever you go on, Cosmic. I'd like to find out who that broken guy is that we were talking about. Oh, wow. I really got a lot that time. And I got 3 credits. All right. We're going good. No. Why did that happen? All those things I worked so hard for are gone. Why did that happen? Whatever. Cosmic, I watch you when you're on, Player's Guide, right? Now, I wouldn't say that. I do find you interesting, especially when you were playing, did I seriously just, man, that totally ruined everything. Night Mew, take care. Cosmic, you were playing that Resident Evil one time, weren't you? Oh, it did beat my high score. Nice. Alright, I'll change games. I'll play something a little bit more entertaining. You're probably going to get a weird screen, but that's because I turned the AES off. This game's there we go. Alright. That's a lot better. Alright, so let's see. This is a multi-card for Neo Geo. I just got this because there's a ton of games on it. It does have the game that we were just playing on here. I'm actually going to try to play Last Resort. You know, that Resident Evil that you were playing looked amazing. I mean, if you don't mind, if you could send like the link or something, or the name of it, of where you, where was it? I believe it was on Steam. I would love to try that out. I like your streams. I mean, you sit there, you get into the game and stuff. I don't find you boring at all. I think you find yourself boring, and I think I talk too much. So, yeah, Nightmare SP. Let's see what Nightmare SP is. Maybe it's the same game. I don't know. This one. Oh. No, it's the same game. This one has weird stuff on it. It's got the, I don't know, I think this version's a little weird to begin with. The SP version. Now, but Cosmic, I'll definitely stop by and next time you stream. Yeah, I like your streams. And that chair looks really comfortable that you stream from. God knows, I need a new computer chair. Mine's done. I can't, like, this is a recliner that I have in this room. then my work chair is behind me. And that work chair is shot. I'm going to be honest with you. I was on a conference call one day and just people were getting rowdy. And I think I broke the left arm off the chair. Just, yeah, I don't know. It's just that chair is like done. It's like, please, you're going back to work, buddy. You're sitting in the office. Just. My chair is 100% falling apart. I sat in it one day and then almost went over and fell on the floor. And my 8-year-old was laughing at me, thinking it was the funniest thing in the world. So, yeah, some support I get from them, right? But, yeah, I definitely need a new chair. I think Slippy's chair looks super comfortable. And those new chairs are ridiculously expensive. You don't recommend? Did you get your chair like off of Wayfair or something? This is what this is. This is a recliner. I play I have the TV in front of me to play like new modern games and stuff like that. And like I said, I have a 27-inch or 28-inch RCA over here from like I think 82 or 83. It was my original TV when I was a kid growing up. So I picked that off of my parents. But behind me is like my work setup when I work from home sometimes, and my chair is like gone. Gone. Like even today I sat in it and I get up and I'm just like, yeah, my I can't move, my back hurts, I'm getting old. I'm like, yeah, whatever. Wow. Really? Damn, $600 chair. Wow. Racing chairs, unless you have like a racing setup. Then I could see, but this is what I'm on right now is a recliner. And that was it. Yeah, I could so see that. I could totally see that. You needing extra support. Grace needs to go for those shots in her back, and she needs definitely a new recliner. The recliner she has now is horrible. So I have to get her. I'm looking to see maybe if I can get her a new recliner. But yeah, her back is pretty. She went on a slide actually at a fair. And it was one of those slides like you use the rug and it goes down and down and down. And yeah, she hit the bottom of the slide, and she went up, boom, and went right down and hurt herself. And I was like, oh, geez. Ever since then, her lower back's not been normal. That was a good haul. Becomes too much. It's like, why are you're like, for the amount of money you're gonna buy and like replacing parts, you could just go ahead and that's it. You get like a new chair. Everything's gone. Move up. That's got to be rough. Did you have really bad, like, I mean, your range of motion must have been horrendous. It's just another thing. Yeah. Hey, you've been through a lot. It's very surprising, to be honest with you. Oh, but I'm going to ship that stuff out this week, and I got the gunner glasses. So I really just don't use them. So if you can use them and they're better for you, then yeah. I mean, it happens, but you know what? You wake up every morning and stuff. I mean, you know, at least that's something to look forward to. You made a good, successful stream channel. Jeez, really? Well, I gotta send stuff to you and to Choco. And I'm doing wow, I'm on 3 credits. But then again, I died that last stage, so what else is new? Oh, and I spoke to the guy about the EverDrives for N64, and the whole thing with what's going on with Russia and the Ukraine. I don't know about those right now. Though that's going to be hard to get a hold of, only for the simple fact that he's in the Ukraine. Yeah. So I gotta see when he's gonna have them, and go from, you know, basically just take it from there. Well, honestly, my N64, I have a couple of games. The only games I have for N64 is Zelda and Castlevania and GoldenEye. That's it. I don't have interest in playing N64 unless it's like Castlevania or Zelda. So he does have them in stock. Okay. My friend's really big into the EverDrive collection, so I gotta ask him which is the best one for the N64. How does your mister go about emulating like N64 and FX chip games, like Star Fox and stuff like that? Does it play them well? Oh, so it doesn't do N64. Okay. Got a hold of it. Okay, good. Right, PS1 and Saturn. Plays Saturn very well. Saturn, though, I think is a pain in the ass to try to emulate anyway. A lot of people have a problem with it. Dreamcast is pretty good. I have a Dreamcast, so I don't really have a lot of games for Dreamcast. I never really had a Dreamcast growing up. I do have Mark of the Wolves, Marvel vs. Capcom 2, Cannon Spike, and those other games. Gumbird, I think. I enjoy Cannon Spike, though, playing that once in a while. I like Cannon Spike. I do. Cannon Spike's a good game. The Dreamcast I have is specific because my friend's really big. Like, he's a big Dreamcast guy. And he told me to, get the one where you could play burnt games. So I have the one that the games are all burnt and you can play the games like that. I was thinking about, for a stream, maybe Tuesday, playing Silhouette Mirage. Oh, was that? Yes. Man, this is a really good run, and I probably just jinxed the living crap out of myself, but yep. I never knew that. That's why they could play hack games. Yeah, I never knew that before with, with the Dreamcast. Alright, so this one I gotta move. These guys are gonna try to ram you. Yeah, these guys are gonna tank me. Damn it. Come on. But, yeah, Eco's on Dreamcast, I think. Wait, you could what? You can? That's new to me. I've never heard that before. And your boy, right? Yep. I got one left. Oh my lord. Dude, I knew he was getting closer. I knew he was getting closer. We almost got him. It's either you or me, buddy. You or me. Let's go. It might be me. Or it might be you. So, what's that? It was a series of... I didn't know that. So you... Wow. So, how do you do that? You take the I did get him, yeah. How do you... So, good call on that one. I just had to move around the stage a little bit and avoid him, but... So, how do you do that? You burn the ISO or something, and that's what you get? That was a total crapshoot on my part. Oh, I didn't even know that. You just let the game up with one of those discs. I gotta look. How much? I wonder how much they're going for on eBay. Caught you. The ISOs are free to download. Jeez. Listen, if you know a place to download PS1 ISOs, let me know. I would gladly go ahead and like try to do that. and see if I could get that disc and go from there. Because I'm not, I mean, PS1, I don't, there's only a few games. I'm not, like, nuts into collecting PS1 or playing, you know, PS1 games or something like that. So hoping that guy was going to run there.
Nope.
Come on, come on. Oh, no, no, no. I'm running out of time. I'm running out of lives. Fire out. Thanks, Slippy. I'll look into that. ROM GitHub. There's a lot of, is there a special, you could just burn, I guess, Dreamcast CDs on anything, right? Doesn't normally have to be any, like, specific CD that you would need. Yeah, I don't want that. Got him. Come on, come on, come on. So, used to be a special program you had to use, but I don't know if it's okay. I'll look it up. I'll see. Oh, come on. Damn, game over. I didn't even know that, to be honest with you. Nice. High score. It's a pretty good score, too, I guess. But, all right. I'm going to go for now, guys. Slippy, thanks for all the information and everything. I appreciate it. I'll reach out to you. Oh, what is that? GD-ROM. I'll look it up. I'll see. And then I'll go from there. But I'm guessing probably Cosmic. I didn't even think about it. I mean, then I would hit start. And then continue to go from there. But I don't know if it would be on second, on the same. No, it would probably be on the same game with the, oh, what is it with the points? But yeah, you'll have 8 credits, right. That's got to be something I got to try, though. But all right, everyone. Thank you, Cosmic. I'll see you later whenever you stream. Hopefully tomorrow. Slippy, I'll be there for the job stream, definitely. Yeah, thanks, Pixel. I appreciate it. Thanks, guys, for coming out. And good night, all. And I will catch you guys tomorrow. Good night. Thanks, guys, for coming again. Appreciate it.